Oh, my munchkin. I'm so glad you could make it.
What did that?
I had a dance with my boyfriend earlier. It was so beautiful. I wish I could dance like that. But I don't have that, you know.
Single dances in your heart.
That's what he said.
You know, I've never been. You should listen to me. 99.99% of the time, I'm right about what you're thinking about.
What?
You're
thinking about the disease?
First round. What? Say it with me. First
round. He's dying. Stop it. Be ashamed of yourself. Oh, and munch. Better grab some food. There's so much to eat.
Anything I can get for you?
Ice cream would be nice.
Careful, Amelia. You might get a food information to gastrointestinal tract.
Ew!
Tell Amelia that I got this urge, drugs, disease, okay? And get her some ice cream. So what? Whatever.
You're hopeless, aren't you?
What?
You're never on time. If you weren't so charming
and drop-dead gorgeous.
I would have ditched you on our first date. Guess I need you after all.
So do I.
Cheers. Turn that off, will you?
Sure. Babe, I've got to take this. It's my mom.
Oh, sorry. Nope.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Brent. I'll be there.
Is everything all right, babe?
Yeah, everything's fine. Just give me a minute, I'll be there.
What's your problem?
It's my, my sister is having an electronics project and there's a short circuit and they're afraid. You know this girl, they're overly paranoid.
Can't you just call someone to fix it? You're in a party, you know?
With dad out of town, they want me to be home before the house versus place. I'm really sorry, babe.
Does this have to be like this all the time, Matthew?
I'm sorry. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
Promises are dangerous, Matthew.
Bye, baby.
Get back in there before you get yourself into more trouble, bro. I don't know how long to talk to this. Well, you brought this upon yourself. So miserable you are. Eddie, where are my clothes?
Last at Shanna's, it's time to get back to business. So, please, I need your full attention. No, I demand it.
That party was awesome. I truly envy Shanna Brent. She has everything, and a cute boyfriend too. I wonder why they didn't introduce him at the party. But then again, he's so dreamy, she probably doesn't want anyone else to know about him. I mean, we don't even see them together at campus.
Ariel, your full attention?
Sorry.
Leave it to the chipmunk to ruin the mood.
Moose!
Guys, please!
So, Sal, what are these?
Additional solicitation letters, of course.
What? But people are chewing our switch!
You got their attention, alright. Guys, you're overreacting. That's just the script.
Oh.
Whee! Okay, Matt, take the floor. This play is originally a medieval period epic. However, because of our budget constraints, we're going to modernize it, and thus we can save on our projects, our props, costumes, and our musical arrangement. I was about to ask help from our club's veteran director, but then we have to pay her as she's already a pro. So we'll have to make every part of this a team effort.
What about the cast?
I'm getting there, Nathan. Anyway, Sabin and I have been trying to fit everyone into their appropriate roles. But with only us eight in the drama club, plus a few occasional sit-ins, then we don't have much of a choice. So we'll just make the most out of what we have right now, shall we? Okay. Sabin will be Tyran. Rod, you'll be Uther. Vinito, you'll be Balinar.
Then I was going to play the lead.
Well, that's it. You just thought you're going to play the lead. Nathan, you'll be Tychondrius. Gustav, you'll be Gabriel. Ariel, you'll be Akasha. And Gary, you'll be our lead star, and Nadio. What? Relax, D. You're going to love it. You'll have fight scenes, lots of fight scenes.
Oh, good. I get to beat Vinito up.
Absolutely, Nathan, too. So start memorizing your lines. Rehearsals start tomorrow. I'll be your director.
No way!
And I will not tolerate foolishness.
Yes, ma'am.
Yada, yada.
I guess that's it. Sap?
Meeting is adjourned. And, oh, please, don't forget your solicitation letters.
Can I talk to you for a moment? Alone. Well, Matthews, is there something that you're not telling me?
Why should I be telling you this?
Because you belong in this club. And whether you like it or not, I have to make sure that you're behaving well. This club cannot and will not be jeopardized just because of you. Am I clear?
What are you talking about?
Oh, let's see. I don't know how long I can keep up with this, Gustav. I heard everything, Matthew.
You're lying.
And why are you so scared?
Look, Mav. I really didn't want for things to go so complicated. I already hooked up with Shadowbrand long before, but I got into this bet to make Amelia Conanheim fall in love with me, and she fell too fast. And I couldn't break up with her without her bursting into tears or talking about how doomed she was. And Alice Steiner, she's just gorgeous.
So that's it.
What? You're bluffing?
So, the story is already true. Rod Matthews, the Casanova, heartbreaker extraordinaire. Now you listen to me, Matthews. I will not tolerate this kind of behavior in this club. You better do something about that and do it fast.
I don't know what to do.
Your problem, not mine. So is there anything else you want to tell me?
I need your help.
That's really funny, Matthews.
Wait, ma'am!
I don't have time for this.
I'll pay for the club's expenses for the play.
Oh, so now, you think you can bribe me?
I'm not bribing you. I'm hiring you. Yes, that's it. I'm hiring you. I'll pay you and I'll pay for the club's expenses.
You should be right.